So hello everybody, welcome to my new video. So today we are going to discuss about the one of the platform which is used, which can be used for doing the online submissions and for doing the practice of programming online. So right now in the situation of this COVID-19, it is very difficult for every college, every technical college, to take online practicals and then take the online submissions of their course programs. So I found a very good application, very good site which makes our task very easy, which helps students and teachers to do these programming tasks online. Okay, so now let's get started with that. So first of all, you have to use this URL, that is www.onlinegdb.com. So go to this URL. This site will open, and here you can see this site is very nice, which comes with an editor. This is an interactive editor. Okay, you will get all whenever you try to type any program, so you will get interactive hints there. Okay, so it is very nice editor that comes with this platform, with which you can type your program, you can write your programs. Okay, so right now it is supporting various programming languages like C, C++, Python, Java, PHP, Ruby, Perl, C#, VB, Swift. So many these many languages are supported by this platform, and in the upcoming days they are going to give the support of other programming languages also. Okay, so but these are the programming languages which are sufficient, which are generally included in every technical syllabus. Okay, so what you have to do, okay, so if you want to do the practice, you can directly, without any account, you can directly type your program in this editor and you can practice your programming. Okay, so you can save your program, you can run your program, you can debug your program, so you can beautify, means you can properly indent your program, you can download your program. So many features are available on this site, you can see. Okay, now I want to tell you that now how we can use this platform for taking the submissions. Okay, because that is the major problem right now for every college. So if you see at the left side, you will get so many options here: menus, ID, my projects, classroom, learn programming, programming questions. So here you will find the new feature which is launched by this application is classroom. So you have to click on this classroom menu option. So I'll click on it. Now it will ask for you the account creation. Okay, so you have the choices here. You have the three choices, that is, you can log in with your Google credentials, Facebook credentials, or GitHub credentials, or else you can create your own account. Okay, so now I'll create my account with the help of Google Plus. Okay, Google. So I'll show you that how you can create the teacher account. Okay, then you can go for the student account. The process is same for the student account also. Okay, so as I'm a teacher, I will tell you that how to create a teacher account. Then choose your email, okay, which you want to use for account creation. Okay, then it will ask for you, okay, early access of online GDB classroom. Okay, so here it will ask whether you are a student or teacher. So I'll select here teacher. So in case of student, you should choose student, don't try to become a teacher. Okay, choose your option student, and then type your college name. So I'll type my college name. Okay, so yeah, okay, so then after that, you need to type here, you need to click on submit button. Okay, so this will create your classroom account. Okay, and here for teacher, it will ask for you to create a classroom. So here I will click on add button. Now it will ask for creating a classroom. So I'll create here, suppose SE, or I'll create here a classroom like object oriented. With my subject name, I'll create a classroom here. So object oriented programming. Okay, and then okay, so it will create an account. Okay, classroom. Then I'll click on this classroom again. Now I'll go into the classroom. Now here it will ask for you the teacher students enrollment. Okay, so here you have to click on invite students. Now this link you need to copy. Okay, and you need to send to your students. Okay, I'll copy it. Okay, and now you need to use this link for inviting students. So right now I'll do one thing. I'll go to in another browser here. I'll try to use this link, okay, and I'll use that link here, and then let's see. Okay, it is again asking for the login. Okay, so now here again I'll try to log in with the Google. Now at this time I'll use my another account, another Gmail account. Okay, so here my account will be, it is already existed. So in your case it will ask you for student or teacher, so there you will use student. Okay, now already I'm enrolled in another classroom, so it is showing my another classroom AC computer and object oriented programming classroom which I have recently created. So I can click on that, my classroom. Now this is my student account. Now it is showing that no assignment published yet. Okay, so now see, I'll do what, I'll go back to teacher account. Now in this teacher account I'll click on this add assignment button. Now here through this I can add a programming assignment. Okay, so it is here asking me for the title. Okay, so I'll write here, okay, title, I'll write here addition of two numbers. Okay, so this is my assignment. Then I can set the due date. So I'll set the due date of tomorrow. Okay, and then tomorrow we can give the time also. So I'll give the same time. Then after that here you can put your detailed construction, detailed description about your assignment. So I'll write a C++ program to add two numbers. Okay, then after that you can put lot many things, whatever you want. You can that instruction, detailed instructions you can put, you can format it with the help of this editor, which is a very nice editor here. And then after that you need to select your programming language in which you want to tell your student to write the program. Okay, then after that you can hear the very good advantage of this platform is that you can do two types of assessments, that is manual and automatic. So I'll choose here automatic. Okay, then after that it will ask for you the test cases, so you need to add the test cases. So here I'll write the test case name test one. Then here I'll give the input. So I'll give the input of two numbers, and then I want here, suppose I want here output 57. Okay, so flexible, I'll keep it flexible. Okay, then or you can make it strict. Again I'll add another test case, and here I will write test two, and here I'll give the input of minus numbers. Okay, and then I'll write the expected output here. Okay, so this way we can add multiple test cases. Okay, these test cases are used for checking your or evaluating your program, okay, which is submitted by the students. And here you can put this sample code template. If you want to share some sample code template with the students, you can put that sample code here. Okay, so now this is done. Now we have to save it. Okay, now it is saved, and now then just click on publish. Okay, so now this assignment is has got published. Now I'll go to the student account, and here I'll just refresh it, and now you can see it is showing the assignment, that is addition of two numbers, its due date, and it is pending. So I'll just click on this. Now student can click on this assignment statement. Now it will show the statement, okay, description of the assignment, write a C++ program to add two numbers, and at the right side the student will get an editor. Okay, here. Okay, so here the student can type the program like this. You can see how the editor is very useful. Okay, then you can type. Okay, so I can write here program like this. Okay, then I can declare two variables. So just a second, I'll write the program. Okay, and then I'll just take the input directly. Okay, n1, then n2, and then sum is equal to n1 plus n2. Okay, and then see out sum. So this simple program I have written here, and then return 0. Okay, and here I can run the program. When I click on run button, at the bottom it shows it shows the input. Now it is asked for the input, so I'll give the input 36 and then 85, and then enter. Now it is showing 121, the addition of that two numbers. Okay, so then after that I can debug this program. Okay, when you click on debug, it will show the debugging screen here. You can use the debugger, a GDB as a debugger. Then you can save this program. I'll click on save. Then you'll get two options here, test and submit. I'll just click on test button. Now it will compile my program, and then it will test against the test cases set by the teacher. Now it is showing that the tests are passed. Out of two tests are passed here. Okay, so that my program, it says that my program is correct. Now I can submit my assignment here. Okay, I'll click on submit. Okay, now my assignment is submitted. Now the good thing is here, after submitting your assignment, you cannot edit that program. You cannot edit it. Okay, you cannot update your program. You cannot change your program. Okay, so this way the student can do the submissions. Okay, through this platform they can run their program, they can debug their program, they can test their program, evaluate their program, and they can submit their program. Now I'll go back to your classroom now. Okay, now here it will show the program is now submitted, status is submitted now. Okay, now I'll go back to the teacher account now, and teacher account, when I refresh it, now it will show one pending for evaluation now, but again I'll yeah, 1 minute, I'll just go inside this. Okay, so yeah, the submission is done, but it is not published yet here. Okay, so it shows here that submission is done. So we'll see here, we'll wait for some time and we'll see. Yeah, 1 minute, we'll just go. Yeah, okay, so it will take some time, but see, whenever your submission is done, it shows the submission is done here. Okay, okay, submission. Okay, here it is showing. Okay, it is showing this student has done the submission. Okay, so submission has been done, evaluated. Okay, so after some time the submission done, here the submission will be visible in the submission done. Okay, so this way you can create, okay, teachers and create multiple assignments here. Okay, just by clicking on add assignment, and then students can do the submissions of those assignments through their student account. So this way you can use onlinegdb.com as a submission platform, as a practice platform, as an online compiler and debugger for your programming languages. Okay, and that is very useful for the students and for the teachers as well. Okay, so I hope you enjoy my this video. I found it is useful for all the teachers and students, so I started recording this video. So thank you for watching my video. If you have any doubt, okay, if you want any other innovative tools for your teaching learning process, you can contact me. Okay, thank you, bye bye.